we're doing some cigarette magic. This is just something that I thought would be kind of cool. Just an idea at this point. But, okay. Magic with cigarettes. You can do this at any point you want in your routine. You can take cigarettes, place them into your hand.
If you would, as I run my thumb down the edge,
say stop, right there. Your card will be placed off of the deck, roughly about halfway down. Once again, just in case you think perhaps I know where it is, I will give the cards a shuffle. Another shuffle. All right. Now, all I have to do at this point is take the pen and cast a shadow of mystery over the cards. And we should find a card with a signature on it. Well, of course, that's my signature we're looking for yours. Oh, it would be on the other side. I'm sorry. Okay. And your card, what was your card?
Ace of Diamonds.
Ace of Diamonds. You know what I'm thinking? Wouldn't it be wild if the card with my signature on the back of it is the card with your signature on the face of it? That'd be quite good.
Take the card like this, you're going to push it in like that.
still holding the card in middle grip with one card separated. As the hands turn over, they briefly touch and there's a transfer of a card. So then when I push this out, once again, it's not their card. I'll show that to you the way it looks to the audience, but slowed down, okay? Imagine I show it to you, we'll get into close view here. That's their card. As I come to point, this hand just brushes up against there, and one card is added. Then I take this fan. Now in one move, I push this in and push it over. And if you time it right, it looks like the card never leaves their sight. They're persuaded of it, because they've seen it face out like this and then like this. And you push it in. Once again, the misdirection of the card in mouth is here, because you go like this. Right? I mean, they're watching there. So you go like that. And then I'll pull it out. Pull it out. I'll show you a really cool trick. You know, you look around at everybody and make faces. Then they find it. Another thing which is very, very powerful is this here, where you take the card, you lose it off of the deck about halfway down, snap your fingers, and bring it up to the top. And that, of course, is just using the top change on the offbeat, but very effective, just with a point or something. And a top change, for those of you that aren't aware of it, is just an exchange of cards, really. And you can learn it from almost any good card. Teach you how to do it. But with a slight point or something, I feel it's really well covered. And then bang, you bring it up to the top. Each time, of course, it comes to the top, prior to that, they're chanting, "Mac drops, Mac drops, Mac drops." You may also want to talk about another feature and a benefit of the drop every time it comes up. Cream always rises to the top, right? Why is that? Because of this, that, and the other things. You're including a little bit of sales message with each one. Probably wind things up pretty quick. I don't want to go too long here. This one relates to customer service. And you have a couple of hats. You can have these guys wearing the hats. At this point, only one. And then, of course, deck of cards, which we're going to do a little bit of magic with here. And just give them a bit of a shuffle first. Okay. Now, what I need you to do if you would is touch a card. Right there? Okay. Do you want to change your mind or you're happy with that one? Okay. It doesn't matter. It's a card which you get selected. Okay. And we're going to lose that off into the deck. Roughly right about there. So at this point, I really don't know where the card would be. It could be anywhere in the deck here. But we'll give them a little bit of a shuffle just to ensure that it is lost off. Now we're going to use these hands. Okay. Wait. It looks good. Okay. One hand there, one hand there. I wish they could be a good jam. Now, what we're going to do here is have a little bit of thought control. Now, basically what this is me understanding what your needs are, what type of a person you are, and being able to predict in advance how to satisfy those needs. And that's what we're all about at Northwest Airlines. You know, we want to anticipate every need you might have and be able to provide it before you even know it's a want. To illustrate that, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to be pulling cards from the deck here and transferring them from this hand to this hand. At any time you want to, you can say stop, and it will be your card. You want to stop now, or do you want to keep going? I mean, we'll keep going.
Keep going.
All right. Now, this can go on all day, and it's totally up to the person when he wants to say stop.
We can stop right now.
With that card there? Last card?
This card right here.
Okay, now, since you said that while my hand is in the hat, I will give you the option of waiting one more or later to be this one.
That one is
good. Okay. Sir, it'll break my heart if it isn't so, but tell me, did we anticipate your needs?
Yes.
Yeah? Stop me whenever you want. And I discovered this in something similar to it anyways. Greater Magic by John Ridley Hellier. And basically, it's a one-way forcing deck using roughing flip. So every second card in this deck is a two of hearts, right? But they come out as pairs with roughing fluid. So you can spread through them, you can overhand shuffle them, and then the pairs stay together. That doesn't disturb their order or anything like that. No matter which card they touch that one right there, it of course is going to be the two of hearts, right? So it works every time. This is a great little deck. I made three of these up, so if anyone wants to buy one of them, I've got three here, which I can sell, and they're all good cards, you know, those that are visual from stage. Also, in the lecture notes here, I do show you how to make your own roughing fluid for about $3. You make like a big spray can full of it. You have to do maybe about, I don't know, five or six decks. It's pretty good. And if you want to make your own blank face cards, I'll show you how to do that. Yeah, I got some lecture notes here. And here's what I propose for that before I get to I'll show you one more thing that I did at a trade show. Actually, I'll show you two more. I'll just do this really quick. This one here was for the very first trade show I ever did. You can tell by the quality of the production here. But we talked about some of the things that you might want to look for in an investment company. So we did this in Jasper Park Lodge and an Acumen Group. They're a financial investment company, and they specialize in handling the affairs of periodontists, dentists, stuff like that. So lifestyle planning, accounting, lawyers, tax lawyers. This is what you want. You need